children, welcome to the video session of Standard 6 History, Term 3, Unit 2. And the lesson name is The Post-Mauryan India. Come, let's enter into the video session.
Let us discuss about the post-Mauryan India in this video session. Introduction. The breakup of Mauryan Empire resulted in the invasions of Sakas, Scythians, Parthians, Indo-Greeks or Bactrian Greeks and Kushanas from the northwest. In the south, Satavahanas became independent after Ashoka's death. There were Sungas and Kanvas in the north before the emergence of Gupta dynasty. Kalinga declared their independence. It has to be noted here that though Magadha ceased to be the premier state of India. Sources. First one is archaeological sources. Inscriptions. Ayodhya inscription of Dhanadeva. Persepolis Nakshi Rustam inscriptions. Mocha Taxila copper plate. Junakad or Girnar inscription. Nasik Prasasati inscription of Darius I. Coins. Coins of Satavahanas. Coins of Cutbasis II. Roman coins. Foreign notice. Huan Shang, the Chinese Buddhist monk and traveler. Literary sources. Puranas. Kargi Samhita. Harsha Charita of Banapata. Mahabhasya of Patanjali. Brihaskatha of Gunadhyaya. Madhyamika Sutra of Nagarjuna. Buddha Charita of Ashwagosha. Malavigagni Mitra of Kalidasa. The Sungas and Kanvas in the North. The Sungas. The last Mauryan Emperor, Brihadratha, was assassinated by his own general, Pushyamitra Sunga, who established his Sunga dynasty in Magadha. Pushyamitra made Pataliputra as his capital. Pushyamitra's kingdom extended westward to include Ujjain and Vidisha. He successfully repulsed the invasion of Bacteria king Menander. But Menander managed to keep Kabul and Sindh. Pushyamitra thwarted an attack from the Kalinga king Karavela. He also conquered Vidarbha. He was a staunch follower of Vedic religion. He performed two Ashwamedha Yagnas, horse sacrifices, to assert his imperial authority. Pushyamitra was succeeded by his son Agnimitra. This Agnimitra is said to be the hero of Kalidasa's Malavik Agnimitra. The drama also refers to the victory of Vasumitra, Agnimitra's son, over the Greeks on the banks of the Sindhu River. The weak successors of Sungas constantly faced threats from the Indo-Bactrians and Indo-Parthians. The Sunga dynasty lasted for about 100 years. The last Sunga king was Devabhuti. He was killed by his own minister Vasudeva Kanva. Vasudeva established the rule of Kanva dynasty in Magadha. Importance of the Sunga period. The Sungas played an important role in defending the Gangetic Valley from the encroachments of the Bactrian Greeks. Pushyamitra and then his successors revived Vedic religious practices and promoted Vaishnavism. Sanskrit gradually gained ascendancy and became the court language. Though Pushyamitra persecuted Buddhists during his reign, the Buddhist monuments at Barhat and Sanchi were renovated and further improved. The great stupa of Sanchi and the railings which enclosed it belong to the Sunga period. King Karavela of Kalinga was a contemporary of the Sungas. We get information about Karavela from the Hathigumba inscription. Next one is the Kanvas. The Kanva dynasty produced four kings and their rule lasted only for 45 years. The history of Magadha after the fall of the Kanvas is devoid of any significance until the emergence of the Gupta dynasty. The Kanva rulers were Vasudeva, Bhumimitra, Narayana, Susarman. The last Kanva ruler, Susarman, was assassinated by his powerful feudatory chief of Andhra named Simuka, who laid the foundation of the Satavahana dynasty. Satavahanas in the south. The Kushanas in the north and the Satavahanas in the south flourished for about 300 years and 450 years respectively. Simuka, the founder of the Satavahana dynasty, is said to have ruled for 23 years. His successor was his brother Krishna. The latter and his nephew Satakarni ruled for 10 years each, establishing an empire, holding control over a vast area stretching from Rajasthan in the northwest to Andhra in the southeast and from Gujarat in the west to Kalinga in the east. Satakarni is said to have performed two horse sacrifices, Ashwamedha Yagna, indicative of his imperial position. Gautamiputra Satakarni was the greatest ruler of the family. In the Nasik Prashasti published by his mother Gautami Balasri, Gautamiputra Satakarni is described as the destroyer of Sakas. Yavanas and Pahlavas, the extent of the empire is also mentioned in the record. Their domain included Maharashtra, North Konkan, Berar, Gujarat, Kathiawar and Malwa. His ship coins are suggestive of Andhra's skill in seafaring and their naval power. The Bogar inscription suggests that South India played an important role in the process of early state formation in Southeast Asia. Contributions of Satavahanas. Literature. The Satavahana king Hala was himself a great scholar of Sanskrit. The Gandhara school of Sanskrit flourished in the Deccan in 2nd century BC. Hala is famous as the author of Satasai, that is Saptasati, 700 stanzas in Prakrit. Art and architecture. The Satavahana rulers were great builders. They began constructing Buddhist stupas in Amaravati. A bronze statue of the standing Buddha discovered in OCEO, an archaeological site in Vietnam, resembles the Amaravati stele. The later Satavahana kings issued lead or bronze coins depicting ships with two masts. A stone seal discovered in Nakhon Pathom in Thailand has the same design. Kantara, Mathura, Amaravati, Bodh Gaya, Sanchi and Barhat were known for splendid monuments and art. The Mathura school of sculpture produced images and life-size statues of the Buddhist, Brahmanical and Jain deities. Indo-Greeks and Indo-Parthians. After the conquest of northwestern India and the Punjab region, Alexander the Great left the conquered territories under provincial governors. Two of its eastern satrapies, Bactria and Parthia, revolted under their Greek governors and declared their independence. The satrapy of Bactria became independent under the leadership of Diodotus I and Parthia under Arsaces. After the decline of the Mauryan Empire, the Greek rulers of Bactria and Parthia started encroaching into the northwestern borderlands of India. The Bactrian and Parthian settlers gradually intermarried and intermixed with the indigenous population. This facilitated the establishment of Indo-Greek and Indo-Parthian colonies along the northwestern part of India. Contributions of Indo-Greeks. Coinage. Indo-Greek rulers introduced a die system and produced properly shaped coins with inscription, symbols and engraved figures on them. Indians learned this art from them. Sculpture. The Kandhara School of Indian Art is heavily indebted to Greek influence. The Greeks were good cave builders. The Mahayana Buddhists learned the art of carving out caves from them and became skilled in rock cut architecture. Sakas. The Indo-Greek rule in India was ended by the Sakas. Sakas as nomads came in huge number and spread all over northern and western India. The Sakas were against the tribe of Turkey nomads. Sakas were Scythians, nomadic ancient Iranians, are known as Sakas in Sanskrit. Saka rule was founded by Mayos or Mogain in the Gandhara region and his capital was Sirkap. His name is mentioned in Mora inscription. His coins bear images of Buddha and Shiva. Rudradaman was the most important and famous king of Sakas. His Junagadh or Girnar inscription was the first inscription in Chaste Sanskrit. In India, the Sakas were assimilated into Indian society. They began to adopt Indian names and practice Indian religious beliefs. The Sakas appointed Kshatrapas or Satraps as provincial governors to administer their territories. Kushanas. The Kushanas formed a section of the Yuchi tribes who inhabited northwestern China in the remote past. In the 1st century BC, the Yuchi tribes were composed of five major sections of which the Kushanas attained political ascendancy over others. The Kushanas overran Bactria and Parthia and gradually established themselves in northern India. Their concentration was mostly in the Punjab, Rajputana and Kathiawar. Kushana rulers were Buddhists. Takshashila and Mathura continued to be great centers of Buddhist learning, attracting students from China and Western Asia. The Kushana kings. First one is Kanishka. Kanishka was the greatest of all the Kushana emperors. He assumed the sovereignty in 78 AD and proclaimed his rule by the foundation of a new era, which later became Saka era. The Kushana capital initially was Kabul. Later it was shifted to Peshawar or Purushpura. Conquests. Kanishka conquered and annexed Kashmir. He waged a successful war against Magadha. He also waged a war against the ruler of Parthia to maintain safety and integrity in his vast empire on the western and southwestern border. After the conquest of Kashmir and Kandhara, he turned his attention towards China. He defeated the Chinese general Pan Xiang and safeguarded the northern borders of India from China's intrusion. His empire extended from Kashmir down to Benares and the Vindhya mountain in the south. It included Kashgar, Yarkand, touching the borders of Persia and Parthia. Religious policy. Kanishka was an ardent Buddhist. Kanishka's empire was a Buddhist empire. Kanishka adopted Buddhism under the influence of Asbaghosha, a celebrated monk from Pataliputra. Though a great warrior and an empire builder, Kanishka was as equal as the exponent and champion of Mahayanism. Kanishka made Buddhism as a state religion and built many stupas and monasteries in Mathura, Taxila, and many other parts of his kingdom. He sent Buddhist missionaries to Tibet, China, and many countries of Central Asia for the propagation of Buddha's gospel. He organized the 4th Buddhist Council at Kundalavana near Srinagar to sort out the differences between the various schools of Buddhism. It was only in this council that Buddhism was split into Hinayanism and Mahayanism. Art and literature. Kanishka was a great patron of art and literature. His court was adorned with a number of Buddhist saints and scholars like Asvaghosha, Vasumitra and Nagarjuna. He founded the town of Kanishkapura in Kashmir and furnished the capital of Purushapura with magnificent public buildings. The Kandhara school of art flourished during his time. The most favorite subject of the Gandhara artist was a carving of sculptures of Buddha. Buddhist learning and culture was taken to China and Mongolia from Takshashila. The great Asiatic culture mingled with Indian Buddhist culture during the Kushanas' time. Kanishka's successors were weak and incompetent. Kushana Empire rapidly disintegrated into a number of small principalities. Let's go through the summary of this lesson with the help of these given points.